I'm your host, Brian Max, racing driver, lover of driving fast, fun things. And on this channel, you get reviews for drivers from drivers. Now we're having a look at this Kia Carnival. Don't call it a minivan because I don't think Kia wants to call it a minivan, but we actually are calling it a minivan because what is it? However, I do have to say it may be the most stylish minivan you can buy today, and it is exceptionally, exceptionally premium in here. Think Genesis. There is just one basic mechanical specification to the Carnival. It's got a 3.5 liter V6, makes 290 horsepower and 262 pounds of torque. There's an 8-speed automatic and it is front wheel drive only. There is no all wheel drive available. On this channel, it's all about the driving experience, and that starts with seating position. And in this Carnival, it's actually quite good. Lots of adjustment in the seat and the steering column to get myself situated perfectly, and that results in a great relationship to the Carnival, to the steering wheel, to the pedals. The only thing I'd like is maybe a little bit more bolstering out of the seat. On the other hand, it's not exactly a sports car driving experience, so you don't need all that much bolstering in the seat. The seat is very comfortable and supportive, and on this top trim, this SX or SX Prestige, it has heated and cooled seats as well as a heated steering wheel. In that way, it's just wonderful. In a lot of ways, it's almost like a Genesis level driving experience in here. At this trim level, there's just so many luxury features. We've got a full digital instrument cluster. We've got the massive digital infotainment screen, heated and cooled seats, all that stuff. And then we've got advanced driver assist systems that work wonderfully as well. You can get this in 7 or 8 passenger configurations. This is a 7 passenger configuration with the, I guess, VIP lounge seating in the second row. There's tons of space there. And of course, you can move the seat. You can get it out of the way for your second row passengers if you've got somebody who needs a little bit more space or some space to work, whatever the case is, you can get that passenger seat out of the way. So there's lots of leg room back there. And for me, I would totally take advantage of that and do some work when I'm riding in a Carnival, that's for sure. The ergonomics are very straightforward and very much Kia-like. You can't really get lost. There's nothing confusing. It's very straightforward. All first level, second level, and even third level ergonomics are very straightforward. It's very easy to adapt. If you're coming from another brand, it's very straightforward and it's easy to live with on a day-to-day basis as well. The infotainment screen just makes the whole infotainment experience easy. It's a very comprehensive system, but I just use it on Apple CarPlay. Works just fine for me. It might have Android Auto, but I don't know anything about Android phones. In terms of spaciousness, well, it's a box on wheels. It's a minivan. There's tons of room in here. You can put all kinds of stuff in this thing. I've had a snowboard in it. I had a bunch of stuff in it. There is no shortage of space inside this Carnival, that's for sure. The only thing I don't care for is folding and stowing those rear seats. Yes, they do it relatively easily, but relative to some other minivan manufacturers out there, they do a better job in terms of executing those stowing and folding disappearing seats. The engineering behind those third row seats in terms of their foldability, whatever we want to call it, is just not quite as polished as some other car makers. That said, they work just fine. There's no real problems with them. It just was a little bit awkward the first couple of times I tried to do that. In terms of acceleration, well, this is a heavy kind of minivan. It will get up to speed just fine. The V6 is lovely. It's very smooth, but this is not the quickest thing on the planet, that's for sure. What you do find from time to time is a little bit of torque steer. Who knew? But yes, it makes enough power that you're going to get a little bit of torque steer if you're getting aggressive with the throttle, but most minivan drivers aren't going to do that, and that's just fine. Otherwise, what I do love about this Carnival in terms of acceleration, the way they've got the drivetrain configured and calibrated is so smooth on upshifts. You can feel it cut spark between shifts so that those upshifts are nice and smooth. It's part of a driving experience that could be called calm, cool, and collected. Given that it's very quiet and very premium, very luxurious in here, it's an overall driving experience that is akin to a luxury vehicle. I'm very impressed in that regard. The V6 makes this a pleasant driving experience as well because it's smooth and and powerful and sounds pretty good as well. I do have to mention that you can tow up to 3,500 pounds with this Carnival, which makes a great argument for the Carnival and not for a crossover. I do like the advanced driver assist systems that are part of this Carnival, good lane keep and good adaptive cruise. It's part of the highway driving assistant feature, works very well on the freeway, and overall it's a very reliable system. Very pleased with it in that regard. In terms of steering, well, it's kind of what you'd expect for a vehicle like this. It's overly assisted, it's got a slow rack, and on top of that, it's got a very large turning radius. So in some other smaller vehicles, like if you were looking at a smaller crossover, for example, it would have typically a shorter turning radius. This one has a longer turning radius, probably a function of the longer wheelbase in this Carnival than a smaller crossover. So in some other smaller vehicles, you could easily do a U-turn, no problem. In some tighter confines, it's going to be a multi-point turn in this Carnival. Braking is actually a highlight, and that's because you've got a lot of control and there's a decent amount of feel from that brake pedal. And of course, as you know, regular viewers of the channel certainly know that your first line of defense is that level of safety. You want a good brake pedal, you want to have confident handling, which this kind of does. This does have all the necessary dynamic characteristics, so you can actually handle this thing and avoid a crash if you need to. Dynamically, this is not something you're going to throw around in corners all that often. It's not that satisfying in the corners. You definitely feel all the weight on the nose. On the other hand, I'm very impressed with the damping. It's got better damping than I would have anticipated for a Kia minivan. Great body and wheel control, and it doesn't get out of sorts in the corners, even on rough surfaces. So you do have confidence in this Carnival's handling. I'm very impressed. When you hit a big road imperfection, a big bump in the road, it doesn't have any secondary movements. I'm very impressed. They did a great job calibrating the suspension in this Carnival. How do you spec your Carnival? Well, here's the thing. There's just one mechanical specification, 3.5 Z6, front wheel drive, 8-speed automatic. That's it. The rest of it is all features and options and depends on what you want. Now, I do have to say that if you have to drive a minivan, why wouldn't you get all of these features of this top trim level? It's an SX in Canada or an SX Prestige in the US. And funny enough, it's 47,000 US and 48,500 Canadian. Who knew? Strange pricing based on what the US and what Canada is doing, making it a bargain here in Canada, that's for sure. But I do appreciate all of the features and all of the functions, everything that comes with this top trim level. If you're looking at a Carnival, buy the one you want, but I do recommend this top trim level. It's lovely in here. It's just a beautiful driving experience. And like I said, if you got to drive a minivan, you might want to get this specification. In terms of fuel consumption, all I've done is city driving, so I think I'm going to skip it. I'm not going to report on it. Regular viewers of the show know that I like using the throttle. That reflects in the fuel consumption number that I'm seeing on the screen, and I'm not going to report on it because it would make this Carnival look unfairly poor in terms of fuel consumption, and that's just not right, so I'm not going to do that. Overall, I'm very impressed with this Carnival, especially at this trim level. It's a lovely place to be. It's a decent thing to drive. It's very calm, cool, and collected, like I mentioned earlier. And to me, for you Americans out there, if you're looking at a Sorento or this, I would recommend this. I did not enjoy the front-wheel drive Sorento. I would recommend looking at this. The engine's different, the transmission's a little bit different, and this is a much better driving experience than the front-drive Sorento. So again, if you're looking at a Sorento, look at this Carnival. And on top of that, it's a very stylish, very attractive thing. It doesn't look like a minivan. I love the way they've styled this as well. It's a very, very good-looking thing. Thanks for hanging out with me today and having a look at this Kia Carnival. Hope you liked this episode, and if you did, well, you're not new to YouTube, you know what to do. Smash the subscribe button, turn on your notifications, like this video, and as always, sharing is caring. So please share this with your friends, especially on Reddit, because on Reddit, they really need to see reviews for drivers from drivers. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them in the comments below, and I'll get back to you as soon as I can. If you want to support the channel, please hit up our merch store. Links here, links below. Lots of great stuff for driving enthusiasts like us, including our very popular line of Save the Manuals merch. Thanks again for watching. We'll see you again next time. And remember, cars don't understeer by themselves, not even Kia Carnivals.